Henry Ford once said, "Don't find fault, find a remedy." Many businesses found success with that concept. It helped shape the economic and social character of our country. That inspiration to find a remedy is alive and well today.
Many of America's historically great success stories carry household names and an impressive legacy that includes philanthropy. A perfect example is Will Keith Kellogg.
W.K. Kellogg is both an industrialist and a philanthropist at the turn of the century. Many people know him for the Kellogg Cereal Company, but what we know him for is his philanthropy in establishing the W.K. Kellogg Foundation in 1930.
Kellogg said his foundation was created to help people help themselves. Today, from its headquarters in Battle Creek, Michigan, the foundation is announcing a new mission statement that defines 21st century needs.
The new mission statement really is a reinforcement of what W.K. Kellogg always wanted, and that is vulnerable children at the focus of all of our program work. So our new mission is to support those families, those communities, those organizations that puts vulnerable children first and offers them an opportunity to be successful and thrive.
The foundation is now setting an important national precedent through a new program called the Food and Fitness Initiative. Its inception came as a result of the health disparities and high rates of obesity and related diseases in children that the foundation recognized within 9 key demographic areas of the country.
So the 9 models that we're looking at across the country are 4 in the East, and they are Holyoke, Massachusetts, Boston, New York City, and Philadelphia, 2 in the Midwest, which is here in Detroit, and in Northeast Iowa, a nice rural collection of counties, and then 3 in the Western Seaboard, that is the Tohono O'odham Apache Indian Reservation, Oakland, California, and Seattle, Washington. We picked these because they are all diverse, and they all have a cultural tie to why food is important and what is happening around childhood obesity.
According to the CDC, more than 30% of U.S. school children today are facing obesity. The health problems facing those in lower income, high crime America, where healthy, fresh foods and safe places to exercise are scarce, are even greater.
New York City has a school system that feeds 850,000 meals a day. And serving 850,000 meals a day, that almost had to have been prepackaged and frozen. Now we're tying them with local farmers so it has fresh nutritional value to their children. And what we're doing is not only providing them great food, but we're trying to put local economy into this by having farmers, you know, reap the benefit of a local market.
Here in Detroit, the foundation is collaborating with a leading community organization called City Connect Detroit and its founder, Geneva Williams.
Detroit has high rates of poverty, obesity, high rates of obesity. And so for us in Detroit, there's a real challenge of trying to help our young people and their families eat and live well, and also play well, because the access to good, healthy food needs to be accompanied by the access to good, healthy recreation.
The initiative here in Detroit includes the spacious Eastern Market, filled with fresh foods, and the DeQuinder Cut, an old railroad which is being renovated into a safe outdoor biking and exercise path connecting downtown Detroit to the farmers market.
Well, you see, we're here in this wonderful market. This is the Eastern Market. It's one of the largest markets of its type in the world. And it's been here for many, 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 many years. And farmers bring their fresh produce and their fresh foods. And you should be here on a Saturday or on a weekend, because people from all over come. We want to make sure that places like these are accessible to everyone.
See, every time we eat something there, it's healthy. So, I mean, they're not only teaching us healthy habits, but they're showing us, like, you can do this. It's not going to be nasty. It's something new. Step out of your comfort zone and try it. Don't be afraid. Here, if you don't want to do it on your own, we're going to push you. We're going to give you the resources and put it in your hands.
So, if we combine good food, great activity, and look at the built environment, we know that that's the 3 secrets to having a healthier community and healthier children.
The health of America is under constant attack from highly processed foods and inactivity. Thankfully, leading philanthropic foundations are taking the initiative by providing struggling communities with healthier choices, setting a new precedent to improve America's health. Since 1930, the W.K. Kellogg Foundation has been a philanthropic leader in the care and well-being of America's children.
I spoke to a woman just the other day on the north edge of Detroit, and she said that her daughter could buy two candy bars for what she could buy an apple, if she could find an apple. Fresh food is just inextricably connected to the health and well-being of our children.
In 2007, the foundation began its groundbreaking food and fitness initiative, giving countless children a healthier start and attacking childhood obesity head on.
Some great people and ideas. We're glad you can join us here on the Profile Series. Be sure to join us again next time for more stories of success. I'm Lou Gossett Jr.
The W.K. Kellogg Foundation, our children, our mission, our future. For more information, visit WKKF.org.